Hi everyone, so today's video is going to be the third part of my haul videos, and it's from my trip to once again Japan. And these items were bought in Osaka and Kyoto, and this haul video is including the larger items or items I bought at an event or a specific store. So yeah, I'm really excited to get started and show you what I have. You can also watch my previous haul videos, and I'll be linking them in the description, so you can just click on those and see what I've shown in those videos as well. I have a lot to go through, so let's get started. The first item I want to show you is this pouch here that I got because I needed a travel wallet or something cute to carry while I shop on my trips. So I got this one of Humming Mint. The new Sanrio character, because I really enjoy deers and that's my favorite animal, and I really like the color of this one too. And I'll show you the back. It looks like this, and then there's two zipper compartments so I can keep all my stuff like my passport and money and cards and stuff like that. So yeah, this is just what it looks like, and this is a metal plaque here. It's pretty nice with Humming Mint written on there. Second item I would like to show you are from this card store called Gamers, and they sell a lot of cards, and I'm not a big huge collector of cards, but I've watched videos on this specific type called School Idol Collection, and I got one box because you can get some rare cards in this one as well. I've seen some opening videos of this, so I got the Aqua version, and it's hard to explain, but I think I'll be doing an unboxing of these. There's different rarities as well, so it's say SR and UR would be one of the rarer ones, and then there's like a SP, which is like the most secret one. If you would like to see this in a unboxing video, let me know. I'm really excited to try this. So I got the Aqua version, and I also got a Muse version as well. I'm excited to find this because I know they don't really sell it out anymore, so I'm happy to have this one as well. So let me know. This is version 2 and this is version 4, and I think some of the cards are shiny as well, so I'm really excited to open these. And I got those at Gamers, and I think they're around 3,000 yen or 3,500 yen, which is $35 in US, or a little bit more in Canadian depending on the conversion. I went to a secondhand anime shop as well when I was in Nipponbashi, and I really enjoyed Nipponbashi because it was very similar to Akihabara in Tokyo. It's just a little bit smaller, and they also have some of my favorite stores as well, which I found the Gamers, and also there's an anime there as well. So what I got from there in the secondhand anime store was a lot of Muse things, and again, I am creating a ichiban on my favorite character, Umi, from Love Live, because she is my favorite. So I'm going to just show you all the items I got. First of all, there's this acrylic keychain of Umi in her angelic angel outfit, and this is a pretty big keychain compared to most, so I think it'd be a really good addition to my bag. So I got that one, and this was 600 yen, which is around $6. I also picked up a whole bunch of rubber straps for her as well. They had a bunch of other members from Muse in different sections, so you had to really hunt to find these items. I'll let you know the name of the store at the end of this video, so just stay tuned if you want to hear that. I got a bunch of these Umi rubber straps. This one here is her Sunny Day Song outfit, which is for 300 yen. This one was a little bit more expensive. I think she's in like a racing outfit, and it's 600 yen, which is around $6. And this one is a metal charm, which I think it's adorable because it has Honoka and Kotori, and is 300 yen as well. So I'm really lucky to find these. Is this Umi button, but it also comes with a little key ring, so that's... it'd be really nice to hang this on my bag, and it's a really cute design because she's a little chibi. Umi badge, and it's in her Fruits outfit, which is one of the URs that's one of my favorites on School Idol Festival, the game. Umi I guess you say mascot charm, and it's in her Kira Kira Sensation outfit, and I really like this one because I did cosplay this outfit at a convention one time, and I did make the outfit myself. It's also shown on my Instagram, which I use for anime related things like my collection and also cosplays that I made as well. I'll link that in the description, you can follow it, and also for more updates on future videos that I'm doing as well. It'd be fun to share this with you guys because I do like anime and it does inspire a lot of my art that I post here on this channel. So yeah, it's really adorable, so I'm happy to get that. A clear file of Umi in her angelic angel outfit, and this was for 300 yen, which is around $3. This is a mini clear file. And then I also picked up this Umi Bokutachi board, and this is one of the song, their final songs, and this is actually from an old ichiban kuji from a long time ago, and they're now selling it for 100 yen, which is $1. So I think this is a really good pickup and a really good find. I saw the other news members being sold for $1 as well, so it was really cool to see, and I had to pick up Umi, so I'm really happy. That's what it looks like. Let me know which character is your favorite from Muse and also Love Life Sunshine. So some other stuff that I got were these blind bags of Love Life Sunshine Aqua, and this is just a whole group. This is a mini clear file and it's a blind bag. Inside you get a random clear file, one of the girls like this, and inside are these two cards. This is a card game, and they won't let you know which one you get, you have to figure it out yourself. So I think that was really cool, and this was only 450 yen for each, so I thought that was really cool, and I picked up three. I don't know if I want to open these for myself or give them as gifts, so I'll see about that. This item I got, which is a little bit of a larger item, is this Riko Sakurachi notebook, and she's in her aquarium outfit, and it's just a plain notebook, but I thought the cover was really cool. Riko is one of my favorite characters from Aqua, and my other favorite character is Daya. So yeah, are food related, I guess, but they also have anime on them. I picked up this cookie box of Homura from Madoka Magica, and I was really excited to see these because I don't see much Madoka Magica merchandise being sold, and they're in their yukatas or kimono outfits, they're maiko versions, so I think that was really cool. So I got Homura, which is my favorite character from Madoka Magica, and also I got Mami as well because I really like her outfit, and they both have different flavors. Homura is chocolate cookies and Mami is vanilla cookies, so I thought that was pretty cool. I can probably enjoy this with some tea or something, so yeah, I'm really happy about that. And these were 720 yen each, which is around $7.20, which is not bad in my opinion. And you get a nice souvenir box, which I think that's a good deal. These items were from Ichiban Kujis, and I did two Ichiban Kujis when I was in Japan. So the first one I did was one of my favorite animes, which is Monogatari. You have a lot of seasons to watch, and I've been watching a lot of it, and I do enjoy the characters, so I did get 5 tickets from there. What an Ichiban Kuji is like a lottery prize where you buy tickets for around $600 yen, and you can win a prize every time. There is also bigger prizes you can win for that amount of money, so it's fun to try and you don't lose out on anything, you still get something. So I thought that was a good thing to try in Japan. I also did it in Tokyo 2 years ago when I was there, and it was really fun, so I wanted to try it again. So the first items I got, since I did it 5 times, were these blind boxes of Monogatari. I got 3 of those, so I got K, which is the rubber strap or the keychains, and these are all the possibilities you can get for these ones. I will be posting this on my Instagram, and you guys can pick which blind boxes that I got from my haul that I should open first, and these are probably part of that series as well. and I'm really excited to find out which ones I have in this one. So yeah, so I have three there. It has like Shinobu on the front with a donut, so maybe I'll get this one because she's one of my favorite characters. And then I got this Senjo Gahara, I think it's like a file or something. They have four pictures in it as well. These are the pictures. Senjo Gahara is one of my favorite characters from Monogatari. And let me show you really quick the inside. So they have four pictures like this. And it's just like a regular folder. So I'm really happy to get this. By itself is a really nice poster kind of too. So that's exciting as well. And I was very lucky because the last ticket I pulled was an F prize, which is actually one of the bigger prizes. And then the guy that was helping me out was like, yatta, or something. And I was like, oh. And then he brings out this like figure of Tsukihi, which I thought that was really awesome because this is one of the bigger prizes that you can win in the Ichiban Kuji. And it's really adorable. And I do like Tsukihi too with the Fire Sisters. It'd be cool if I got Karen Araragi as well to match, but I was just really excited to get a big prize in the first place. And this is what she looks like all set up with the stand and everything. And I'll definitely be displaying this for sure because, you know, I won it, so I'm pretty happy about that. So this is just the items I got from that Ichiban Kuji. The next items are a little bit bigger, but they were for free. I did pick them up at an arcade. It's actually Love Live related, and I went to go see the after school activity machines. What that is a game that it's like a rhythm game, just like School Idol Festival, but it's actually like an arcade game. It's new in Japan, so I thought I'd check it out. I'll put a picture right here just to let you know. So yeah, I went to go see that, and right beside it were some flyers for that. So a lot of my friends do like playing Square Idol Festival, so I thought I'd pick up some of the flyers from that game as well. So this is what it looks like, and they're on their new outfits for school, after school activity, and I was so excited to see this. And this is just some of the merchandise that they have for this. And I thought that was pretty cool, so we can check that out if they want. This is some of the cards you can get for that game, because you can play with one of the cards. And this is just Muse in there with a group. And this is what the game looks like. They're all like live like this, and it's a rhythm game again, so you tap the buttons on there. So yeah, I thought this was really cool. And then when you get one of these, it also comes with a mini flyer poster kind of thing, which I think that's pretty cool. And I grabbed a whole bunch of it because the store owners didn't seem to mind how many I took, so yeah, I really wanted to keep some of these as a souvenir anyway, maybe hang it up on my wall, so I thought that was really cool. And I got some for my friends as well, so they can look at them. So these are just the other ones that I picked up. There's more, so yay! Another Ichiban Kuji while I was there. I only got three tickets, but it's the Love Life Sunshine Ichiban Kuji, and they're having a small one. You can get, if I have a picture, I'll show you the full list of all the prizes you can get. It's right here. And I only got three tickets, so I got some of the smaller prizes and one a little bit bigger prize. So first one I have is this blind box with a rubber strap. I had two of them. I opened one in a video, which is the first video of my blind box series from here. So this is Aqua in these outfits here. And Riko is in her piano recital outfit from the episode, if you guys watched Love Live Sunshine in season 1. I really want Riko and Daya, they're both my favorite characters. If not, any of the girls is fine because I never had these before, so yeah. And then I got a K prize, which is a Aqua towel or blanket, and it is of Daya. I got to choose which one because they had a variety. They didn't have Riko, so I picked Daya instead because I didn't really get any merch from her yet. And this is just an overall of what it looks like. This is basically the design here. And yeah, those are just the Ichiban Kujis I did in Japan. I only did two, but hopefully if I go back, there'll be other ones. And they do happen randomly, during the season and whatever they have out at the time, so it was just by random I went into those ones. Another store that I went to in Kyoto was also I found the KyoAni shop, or Kyoto Animation store, which is one of my favorite animation studios. It made a lot of my favorite anime, and the animation is beautiful. It's animated really well, and the characters are very captivating, and the story, I really like the stories as well. Some of my favorites from there are like Kyokai no Kanata, Keion, Tanako Market, any of those ones. I thought that was awesome. And also Hibike Euphonium, which is one of the newer ones, and I really enjoy that one as well. They also have, a store, and they also have a studio, which I visit both. I'll probably have a vlog video, and you probably could see what those look like. I'll put some brief pictures right now if you are curious to see, but it was really fun to go there and get that experience. So I had to go get something from the shop, obviously, to accommodate like that I was there. So the first thing I picked up were a few buttons. So the first one I got was this Nichijou button, and I got it of Sakamoto-san. So yeah, it's really adorable, and this is the official Kyoto Animation sticker they put on all their merch. So I got that button there. I picked up a lot of buttons because, you know, they're pretty inexpensive, and I had to, you know, get something from KyoAni. I don't really see KyoAni merch too often, so I kind of had to go nuts and pick up a lot of things. There's also one from another series that I enjoyed, which is Hibike Euphonium. There's Kumiko and Reina. And again, they have the Kyoto Animation sticker, official sticker. And from that series, I picked up one of my favorite characters from Hibike is Asuka. And I picked up an acrylic charm of her. She's so adorable. And there's also other ones. This is her summer ensemble, which is her summer uniform. And it's a really sturdy acrylic charm, which I thought was awesome. It's pretty thick as well. And these are the other characters you can get. I really debated on getting Reina as well, or Kumiko, because they're also two of my favorite characters. But I only had so much money that I brought with me at the time, so I kind of just waited out, just got my favorite, which is Asuka right here. So if you want to know the other possibilities, these are the ones. So other buttons that I picked up was from Tamako Market. I got two characters, which is my favorite, Tamako, of course, the main character. Again, here's the official Kyo Animation license sticker. I'll show you the other one. It's right here. This one has a gold, like, shiny foil on it too, so I thought that was pretty cool. And the next one from Tanako Market I got is Kana, because she's one of my favorites too, and she's super cute. If you haven't watched, I really recommend it. It's a really cute, fun anime. And I also got one of my favorite characters from the anime Keion as well, and I got Mio Akiyama, which is my favorite character from Keion. So yep. And I got, again, this is the seal, official seal. So she looks really pretty in this one. New series, but they do have merch on it, so I thought I would pick some up. Again, these are buttons, but they're also from a gashapon machine. So I got this gashapon right here. I'm not going to show which one I got since I want to do a video on it, and you can pick one of these gashapons to open. So I got this one. And also this one right here. So there are two buttons from Kobayashi-san Maid Dragon. If you don't know what Kobayashi-san is, it's actually this one here. And I did get a clear file on Kobayashi Maid Dragon. And these have all my favorite characters on it, like the main four. So I'm really happy about that. So yeah, this is a really cute anime as well, if you haven't seen it. And this is my favorite character here, which her name is Kana as well. And this is Toru. They have their names on the clear file. I just noticed that. So yeah. When you purchase stuff from the KyoAni shop, they give you different bags that you can pick to carry your items. Variety of designs, so I chose one of my favorites, which is a Hibike euphonium, and it has a euphonium on it, so it just says sound euphonium. And it says that right there. Another bag you can get is their official mascot, just a regular normal bag like this, and it says Kyoani Shop, which I thought that was really cool. So they have different bags you can carry when you purchase from the shop. And this is an overview of all the things I got from the Kyoani shop. So yeah, let me know which is your favorite item, or if you've seen any Kyoani animes, because I do really recommend it. And last but not least, for the larger items, I did pick up a second Ichiban bag, and this one is in pink. The one I have now is a light blue for Umi. So a light pink I'm going to save for probably another character, maybe Riko or Daya from Love Life Sunshine, because I did pick a lot of Love Life Sunshine blind boxes, so maybe I'll get my favorite characters and put them on this Ichiban bag. So I'm really happy. And this one has snaps, and it snaps on like this. These were 2,500 yen, so they're $25 each, and it's a fairly large bag. As you can see, it doesn't really fit in the screen, so I'm happy to have this. And this is the clear part you put on top. So yeah, if you do want to pick up Ichiban bags in Japan, Animate is a really good store to pick those up for $25 or so. And that's where I found mine. So if you're looking for those, I recommend it there. Or you can try, if you don't live in Japan or have a way of getting there, you can always try to find one online. I can link some in the description if you're curious. Just let me know if you'd like to let you guys know where I get some of my stuff. So just message me, I'm totally okay with that. And before I forget, the secondhand anime store that I got most of the Umi items is called Lashibang, and I'll put how it's spelled right here. So Lashibang is a really good store if you're ever in Japan. I really recommend you go find one. It's like a secondhand anime store, so they do sell a lot of items that you don't really see that often anymore, and like your favorite old anime series. And they don't sell merch on it usually because they have the new anime merch coming out. So Lashibang is really good for the items that you're looking for that you've missed out on, and they could be in that store for a pretty cheap price, or a pretty decent price in my opinion. So yeah, if you have any questions, just let me know in the comments. So this is just a close-up on a few of the items that I picked up, the larger items for this haul. I really hope you liked this part 3 of my haul video, the final and last part. Again, let me know what was your favorite item, and also feel free to check out my Instagram, where I post most of my anime stuff that I pick up, and also my cosplays as well, if you do want to see what kind of items I do get, and also what blind boxes I should open up next in another video. Again, thanks so much for watching till the end, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye!